been joined by Super Foodie Melissa Leong all morning, and now she's going to cook for us one of her favourite dishes. And what is that, Melissa?
Well, what we're cooking this morning is one of my favourite things from childhood, actually. This is one of the first recipes I ever learned how to cook, and it's pork and prawn wontons with black vinegar and chilli dressing.
Ooh, that sounds tricky. Yeah.
Well, this is the thing. I love recipes that sound hard, but are actually very easy to pull off. That way you can kind of get the credit for it.
Yeah, all right. Well, and, let's get started. What do you want us to do?
Okay, well, first of all...
I'm going to do the prawns.
Okay.
All we need to do is peel and de-vein some prawns chop it up really coarsely.
Is it really a vein?
It's look. Oh, wow. Let's be honest. It's a poo
shoot. I knew it.
It is.
I knew it.
But it's fine. I think that you've got it very well in hand there.
Okay.
And,
yes.
You're very confident. So what we'll do is take about 300 grams of pork mince, and we'll just pop that in the bowl.
This one here. Yep.
Yep. And then after that, I'll get you to just grate about a thumb-sized piece of ginger.
Can I ask you a question? Because I find peeling ginger is really tricky. Do you need to take the skin off before you grate it?
If it's old ginger, and this is.
Yep, keep going.
This is old ginger, so I mean, usually what I would do is just sort of take a knife and just very, very roughly. You don't have to be too careful at all.
Okay.
But if you find ginger in season and it's young and it's sort of almost translucent on the outside, just go for broke. Wash it and grate it, and that's really about it.
Okay.
So I'll just get you to grate that.
The whole thing?
The whole thing.
Okay, I do love ginger.
And the great thing about this recipe...
On the smaller one?
On the smaller one, please. And I've just got some water chestnuts here, and I'm just going to coarsely chop those as well.
How are you going over there, Carragalotta?
I'm good, darling. I'm just getting the vein out. We don't want the poo track.
And what's your trick to de-veining the prawn?
Look, you just pull it out like that. Boom.
Wow, you've done that a few times.
What's your trick? So I always like to just pull the head off.
Yeah.
Start peeling the body.
I pull the head off like that.
Yep.
Then I just go like that with the legs, and then I squeeze the tail, and it pops out.
That's exactly what I do. Perfect.
Poor little prawn.
Oh, they're going to be delicious, though.
They are going to be delicious.
That's pretty good.
All right.
Okay, so just coarsely chop the water chestnuts, and we're just going to pop them in there, so I'll get you to do that. Mm-hmm. And then I just have a couple of spring onions, or we sometimes call them scallions as well.
Yes.
And we're just going to, again... give that a bit of a rough chop. The great thing about this recipe is that you don't need amazing knife skills to be able to pull this one off.
So it's all just rough chop.
Just rough chop.
Perfect.
It's four steps, really. It's just about prep, mix, fill the wontons, and then you just pop them in the boiling water and you cook them exactly like you would ravioli once they rise to the top.
Fantastic.
You fish them out and dress them, and then they're ready to eat. So it's really nice and simple.
So I'm giving this a bit of a mix through.
Absolutely.
So we've got...
Perfect. So it's really just the important thing about any kind of filled dumpling, whether or not that's a ravioli or a dumpling, is just to really give it a nice mix so that there's an even amount of everything all together. Otherwise, you don't really want to just bite into a whole mouthful of water.
That is a very good tip. You've also got some coriander ready to go.
Yep.
Do you chop that, or do you like tearing it?
Again, I'm going to just actually use the stalks in the dumpling itself and use some of the leaves as a garnish.
Okay. While you keep chopping, I might start adding some of the liquids.
Absolutely. So about a tablespoon. Look, in Asian cooking, a lot of it's by eye and by appropriation.
Wish I could do that.
I would say a good slug, but about a tablespoon or thereabouts is about what you need.
We need a bottle opener.
Where did they sharpen this knife on
Burton's
head? 1982. Okay, so we've got some extra virgin olive oil here.
We don't need that just yet.
Okay.
We just need the sweet soy. Oh, we need a bottle opener.
Yeah, we've got that coming.
Excellent.
So you've got this special type of vinegar.
So this black vinegar you can get at any supermarket these days, and this is actually for the dressing, so we don't actually need that immediately. Mm-hmm. The great thing about something like this, we don't need that in there at all, but you can add some if you like. The two things are going to end up in your mouth at the same time anyway, so that's okay. That's fine. Again, about Asian cooking, it's all about... going with your gut.
Okay.
If your gut's telling you black
Andrew,
vinegar,
do you want to pop in, matey? We'll get these open. So we've got some light soy. Thank you, my dear. And again, a good slug of
that. A good slug of light soy and some ketchup manis, which is like a sweet, almost like a caramelly kind of soy.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to season the wonton filling.
Okay.
Great.
Darling, how many prawns do you want?
Great. Perfect.
Is that
Thank
enough?
Thank you so much. Well, I'm so lucky today. I have... the most amazing helpers.
Hey, we're little sous chefs over here, aren't we?
Wonderful.
All right.
Okay, so
smells I'm gonna really go home smelling like an old snapper.
All right.
Did you say slapper or snapper?
Snapper.
Oh goodness.
All right.
Okay, would you please hand me the olive oil?
The olive oil, yes.
So here's my tip for getting perfect wontons is to actually take a little bit of the filling and cook it off just so that you can taste it. So you're not eating raw mince.
Yes.
And that way you can adjust the seasoning. If it needs a little bit of extra salt or it needs a little bit of sweetness, you can adjust that and fix the whole batch before you make a whole lot of wontons that don't taste their best.
Okay.
So you don't put much oil in?
Well, we're only just going to fry off just a little bit of the mixture just to see how it tastes, because then we're going to actually boil them, which is a lot healthier than frying them, although pretty tasty when you fry anything, so it's not quite hot enough. That's all right.
Okay, so while that's just frying off, can you tell us about the wontons
pastry,
themselves,
the pastry.
Yeah. Yep. Did you get these just from Asian supermarkets?
I got it from the supermarket.
Oh, right.
General. So almost every major supermarket these days has a great section in the chilled section where you can buy fresh noodles and you can buy wonton wrappers. Ooh, they're so much easier than making them. So I would absolutely recommend just buying them and having a packet. You can store them in the freezer and make dumplings whenever
you like. We are going to start stuffing these wontons, me, Melissa, and our snappy here. And we'll be back in a sec. You're watching Studio 10. We are making wontons. These are ready to pop into some boiling water. Let's throw those in. While we do that, actually, I might get you to do that, Joe, to pop those into
the water.
I haven't
even deveined the prawn.
We want to see how to assemble a wonton.
Well, you've got a bit of a trick. It's super, super easy.
Yes.
Oh. About a teaspoon of the mixture, and you can have mixed that and let it marinate for a little while first. Mm-hmm. Don't get too greedy. Don't put too much, otherwise they'll bust open when you cook them.
Okay.
So about a teaspoon into the centre. So I'll get you to do one.
Yep.
And then all I need to do is dip your finger in a little bit of water and just wet two adjacent sides and fold it in half.
Oh. And pop it in.
And that's it. So you just need to make sure it's properly sealed. So I'd like to give it a bit of a flatten like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then just drop it into the water and that's all you do.
These are our prawn and pork wontons. How long have they been in the boiling water for?
About a minute or two. The secret to this is you drop them into a decent amount of boiling water and once they rise to the top, they're cooked.
They're done like ravioli.
So, again, that's why you don't overstuff them, as you don't want to have too much meat in there. Now, we might just dress these beautiful dumplings with some gorgeous sauce.
Yeah,
I know you're really hungry.
I didn't do it.
And you're wearing white.
I know. So what's this?
The dressing is very simple. It's a similar ingredients to what we actually marinated with. So the ketchup mayonnaise, or the sweet soy, some black vinegar, and some chili oil.
Are we going to taste or am I the only one?
Go.
Let's grab one of these. Here we go.
Oh, my God.
Lean forward, darling. Lean forward.